And now, live from the Ring of Fire, Mike Papantonio.
I'm sitting here with Rick Outzen. We're going to lead off talking to you about Ayn Rand. Why? Because she is the new face of the Republican Party. She's the new face of the teabagger movement. If you listen to Republican leadership talk about Ayn Rand, you might conclude that it's their hope that Ayn should be a candidate for sainthood or maybe some type of lesser Christian deity. I'm not kidding you. Listen to what Republicans are saying about this woman. Unfortunately, for Republican leadership, they don't actually read books or do any meaningful due diligence before they engage their mouth into stupid. If they did, they'd know that Ayn Rand would make an incredibly ridiculous Christian saint since she was an atheist. She believed that the teachings of Jesus Christ made his followers, according to her, weak-minded, naive personalities who'd been defrauded by Christianity, according to Ayn Rand, who is now the talking head, the face for the teabagger movement, for the Republican, the new Republican leadership. Paul Rand is saying she is his hero. That is the new face of what's going on out there. They love Ayn Rand so much that Republican leadership helped produce a full-length motion picture based on one of her novels. It's a film that doesn't mention that Ayn was a vocal atheist who believed that Hitler had some really good ideas about government. Ayn Rand has more quotes than you can count that made it clear that she believed that religion, compassion, taking care of our fellow man was weak-minded. In no fewer than half a dozen interviews, Rand tells us that God not only is dead, but there never was a God. Ayn Rand, the talking head for the Tea Party movement, the new hero of the Republican Party, tells us that poor people, physically disabled people, are a drain on the system of capitalism because they're too damn weak to take care of themselves. Those aren't my words. Those are Ayn Rand's words. I'm not saying this. Paul Ryan, the guy out there that wants to lead us in a new economic upheaval, Paul Ryan is saying this is his hero. When Paul ran at least a dozen times on behalf of Republicans everywhere across the country, Ryan's been in front of TV cameras telling us that Ayn Rand is a stellar example of what Republicans and teabaggers believe in and what teabaggers and Republicans need to become. I'm sure somewhere along the line, someone read him this quote. Here is her quote, ladies and gentlemen. Faith, quote, "Faith is the worst curse of mankind. It is the enemy of clear thought." That's the person, Ayn Rand, who said that. That's the person who Paul Rand says is now the person that he believes in for good leadership in this country, that if we can just follow her, everything's going to be okay. She also said this, quote, "When I die, I hope to go to your place called heaven, whatever the hell that is." That's the hero, the new face of the Republican teabagger movement. That is who Paul Rand is up there saying he wants to lead the new move, the new vision. Today, go to the teabagger website. It's teabagger.dumb. I don't, tell me, what is the website, Rick? It's teapartypatriots.org. Go to that website or go to the Newsbusters. Even more interesting, go to the Newsbusters. Newsbusters is something created by that inheritance baby, Brent Bozell. He created this inheritance baby. He's never worked a day in his life. Says he can feel America's pain. Go to the Newsbuster site, and they say that Atlas Shrugged, this new movie that they had to pay, that somebody had to pay for, Republicans had to pay for, this new movie that talks about the vision of Ayn Rand is what the Republicans need to become. I am not making that up. We got time for a hit on that. Let's play Ayn Rand montage. Number one, let me hear it.
Ayn Rand, more than anyone else, did a fantastic job of explaining the morality of capitalism, the morality of individualism.
Rand celebrates capitalism and the individual.
There were certain writers that just had this vision of the future.
I got to tell you something. What you just heard, what you've got is Paul Ryan out there talking about what a genius Ayn Rand is. time after time. It wasn't just Paul. It wasn't just Paul Ryan. It was all the talking heads. It was Hannity. But I'm not kidding. You go to this thing called Newsbusters. It's a barely breathing site. It's something that the neocons put together because they felt like they weren't being treated fair. They're put together by this inheritance baby, Brent Bozell. He is the guy. The only place to find this oddball is on Fox. He has this joyless, suffering expression, unable to smile, unable to say anything nice about anybody, but he thinks Ayn Rand is the new vision for this country. And I got to tell you something, if she's what's happening with the Republican movement, it's a very scary place because the RNC headquarters is starting to look like Area 51. It's that scary. It's that kind of Ayn Rand thinking that America needs today, according to Republican leadership. Am I making that up?
No. Don't you have to wear a tinfoil hat when you read this to keep the waves out of your head?
Rick, let me just ask you something. How do you embrace something? Do you say that I just didn't know? Do you say, understand what's happening here? These people are, they produced a movie called Atlas Shrugged. It was a terrible, terrible disaster. Terrible disaster. You know, I think 1.7 million the first week or 2 weeks. But the point is this. The story is about the fact that Ayn Rand was panned even when she was alive. I mean, they called what she had to say mindless gibberish. Conservatives back then were mortified that she even called herself a conservative. They were embarrassed by her. Of course, that didn't stop Alan Greenspan by saying that she's something that is good for this economy.
Well, it's all about selfishness, Mike. It's all about, you know, she says it's okay to be selfish. She's the gateway drug for the Republican right more than anything else we've ever seen. And what's crazy, the Tea Party group, they're coming out and they're calling Atlas Shrugged the American Second Declaration of Independence. They don't even know the First Declaration of Independence, but they're going to call it the Second Declaration of Independence. It is, she's sort of the L. Ron Hubbard of the conservative right.
Let's talk about it. Give us a call. 877, we got Ed. Just give us a call. We want to talk about this. We want to start the show by taking your calls on this topic because we couldn't make this up. If we could have heard the rest of that recording, for some reason, I think it broke down. What you would have heard basically is Ayn Rand being asked, what does she think of God? And she's going to tell you she doesn't believe there is a God. She was asked the question, what do you think about taking care of people in this country? And she would say, it's not our responsibility. It's somebody else's, and we're weak to take care of disabled and poor people in this country. Now, let me hear the rest of it. I'm not making this up. Go ahead and put it on.
Atlas Shrugged is out, so you got to get a scene from that new movie.
Okay, let me go.
I am a big fan of Ayn Rand. I've read all of her novels.
And so if Ayn Rand were here today, I think she would do a great job in showing us just how wrong what government is doing is.
You say that you do not like the altruism by which we live. You like a certain kind of Ayn Randist selfishness.
I say that I don't like is too weak a word. I consider it evil because we are now moving towards complete collectivism or socialism. And we are moving that way only because of our altruist morality.
Yes. Now, one of the principal achievements of this country in the past 20 years particularly, I think most people agree, is the gradual growth of social protective legislation based on the principle that we are our brother's keepers.
I feel that it is terrible that you see destruction all around you and that you are moving toward disaster until and unless all those welfare state conceptions have been reversed and rejected.
You are out to destroy almost every edifice in the contemporary American way of life, our Judeo-Christian religion, our modified government-regulated capitalism, our rule by the majority will. Other reviews have said that you scorn churches and the concept of God. Are these accurate criticisms?
Yes.
Christ, every important moral leader in man's history, has taught us that we should love one another. Why, then, is this kind of love, in your mind, immoral?
It is immoral if it is a love placed above oneself.
And then if a man is weak or a woman is weak, then he is beyond love?
He certainly does not deserve it.
Because it's that kind of thinking, that kind of writing that is sorely needed right now.
That is the new voice of the Republican Party, ladies and gentlemen. I didn't make that up. That was Ayn Rand that you heard being interviewed, and that was Paul Paul Rand. I'm going to call him Paul Rand, not Paul Ryan. That was Paul Rand, who was saying that is the new voice of the Republican Party. We're all living.